If planes could talk, one throttle-thumping beast would scream, "Don't you dare mess with me."
It's the sound of freedom.
Unless you're the bad guy, and then it's the sound of pain.
F-16.
It's the sports car of sports cars.
Viper.
It's the hottest thing in the Air Force right now.
Fighting Falcon.
People say, how fast can it go? I say, how fast do you want to go? Because we go that fast.
Lieutenant Colonel Travis Atchison's logged 2,000 hours behind the stick.
We think we are the cat's meow, and nobody does it better.
But we had to get Pentagon approval before I got one.
You need to know how lucky you are to get this ride. I'm sure if we went out downtown Des Moines, we could get a list a mile long of people who would love to have the ride.
200 times a month.
I'm a security forces controller.
The F-16's launch.
I'm a network administrator for the 132nd Fighter Wing.
Giving everyone on base plenty of practice.
We're responsible for servicing the airplane.
Before my flight, I needed a physical, a flight suit.
How cool is that?
And two barf bags.
Can I even tell people to pre-roll them?
Yep.
Just in case.
And then there were the hours of training.
Kneel it down and you can tell it.
How to use the rocket-powered ejection seat.
This is the switch to a rocket motor you're sitting on. Be nice to it.
How to parachute.
Steer using these into the wind. Okay, so now I've had my flight training, but now it's time for the real preparation. Oatmeal and a banana.
I was told they taste the same both ways. Yeah. While crew members check the two-seater we'll be flying.
Making sure the backup emergency systems are operating in case he was to ever utilize it.
My pilot, call sign Chicken, prepared me for 9 times normal gravity, 9 Gs.
Here we go, here we go! It's under G, the oxygen from our nuggets will want to pool to our feet, and that's bad because when that happens, that's when we could potentially black out.
A G-suit, kind of like air-filled chaps, will squeeze my lower body, but I'll have to squeeze and breathe correctly, too.
You're gonna play a little Top Gun music right there.
Can you feel it? Can you feel it? There it is. There's our plane right there.
I can feel it. There it is. Holy cow.
Living it.
This is cool. Okay, this is gonna be cool.
I'll sit right behind Chicken.
Buckled in.
After one last check,
let's go.
We roll.
Okay, one will set the takeoff at runway 23.
With a fireball screaming behind me, this is takeoff.
Afterburner selected. You can feel it kicking in.
Yep.
Gears coming up. I'm holding the nose down. Holding the nose down. Look outside. Look outside. To my departure, Hawk 8-1, we're airborne. Passing 2,000 for 10,000.
Hawk 8-1, Des Moines departure. Radar contact.
From zero to whatever I went was incredible. And then all of a sudden, straight up. Wow.
Pretty much go from zero to 9,000 feet in about 5 seconds, which is the coolest, my favorite part of the ride.
Look out your right shoulder.
Oh, that is cool.
Is that cool or what?
6 minutes after takeoff, we were over Jefferson. Then, with the flip of his wrist, Chicken put Jefferson over us.
I'm going to do an aileron roll. I always like to go upside down simply because you can in this airplane.
Oh, that's cool.
It's cool, and it's just as there's 2.5 G's. That's 2.5 G's, no big deal.
Rolling one way first, then the other.
And now I'm just going to do an easy aileron to the right. And again, you just go upside down because you can. It's so freaking cool.
Oh, that's cool.
If watching this makes you sick, imagine living it.
Very good. The plane is working great. I want you to go ahead and I want you to take the stick of throttle.
Afterburners are so powerful.
Afterburner selected. You can feel it kicking in.
Yep.
They can shove you deep into your rocket-powered ejection seat.
Oh, that is cool.
Or they can suck you right in.
I actually drove by and saw one of the fighter wings take off, or the fighter jets, and that was what motivated me.
This sight convinced Katie to join the Air Guard. She and 1,000 others in Des Moines are on alert, ready to be deployed.
Within 2 days, we can be full up flying combat missions and doing that round the clock 24/7.
Everybody here has a very, very key part in the integration of this machine to make that jet fly.
Look at the cockpit. Who's got their name on the jet?
But very few get their name on the jet and get to sit here.
Okay, you can really get a sensation of the speed right now.
Wow, yeah.
Screaming across Iowa at a smooth 750 miles an hour, Travis Atchison, or Chicken, is flying. I'm riding.
This machine does not want to go slow.
15 minutes into our flight, we'd already rolled it over.
And again, you just go upside down because you can. It's so freaking cool.
Oh, that's cool.
But even cooler, hearing an F-16 pilot say this.
I want you to go ahead and I want you to take the stick of throttle. And I want you to go ahead and fly the thing.
Okay. Put a $35 million fighter jet in your hands, and what would you do?
Here we go. Keep pressure going to the left. Keep going. The plane's just so maneuverable. And that.
Oh, wow.
If you could only see the smile under my mask. But to feel the real power, Chicken took back the stick and pulled a hard left.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a left-hand turn, and I want you to go ahead and get on your strain. And I go, and then I go like this, there's 4.5, and there's 5 G's right there, ready, and stop. Okay, that's fine. We pulled 5.2 G's right there.
At 5 G's, think of 900 pounds of pressure shoving you and every drop of your blood deep into your seat. To keep blood in my head, my flight suit helped me clench every muscle in my body. I'd been prepared.
That felt easier than I expected it to be. I expected 5 G's to be incredible. 5G was doable.
But for the absolute ultimate, we had to nearly double that.
I think we're ready to go ahead and go for the 9G maneuver.
Chicken was cooking up the most wicked, diabolical move an F-16 can handle. Going west at 18,000 feet, he'd flip us over and crank back the stick, plummeting a mid-air mile before pulling out the other way. I'd have nearly a ton of pressure on me. I've never been so scared or excited.
Go ahead and get on it. Okay.
9 times gravity is so wicked, it'll whip vapor trails out of thin air, bend video cameras, and, if you don't breathe right, suck the blood right out of your head.
Oh, I blacked out there for a second.
That's okay.
I remember going into the 9G, I remember pulling, and then I don't remember anything. I blacked out.
I could hear you breathe, and then you stopped breathing.
I felt like I was dreaming.
After 8 unconscious seconds, I shook awake, completely confused.
And all of a sudden, my eyes opened and I was like, holy crap, I'm in an F-16, that's right, I'm up here.
While Chicken took it easy, I recovered, grabbed a sip, a deep breath, and then...
Then I was like, okay, I need a little time here. Grabbed the bag.
The white plastic bag I'd packed.
It was as close to puking as I could get, but I didn't puke.
I'd been whipped, but I survived 9 G's.
And then all of a sudden, it was time to come home, and I was like, wait, we're already on our way home? This is nuts.
We saw cloud-covered farm fields zip by.
You really get to see how beautiful Iowa is, and how rural it is, and how flat it is.
Left Sailorville in the dust, and circled downtown in seconds before touching down.
Wow, that was awesome.
We've made it.
Still a little light-headed.
As a guy who's been flying for 15 years, that was even hard on me, so I can't imagine physically how that was on you.
Ask anyone out here, and they'll tell you.
I find it hard to believe that we get paid to do what we do.
But an hour of jaw-dropping views and insane maneuvers prove Iowa's Air Guard is ready.
Everything that we do, it puts us at the top of the list.